Hello friends, I still remember the time when I did my first options trade. I was not sure if I have done all the necessary steps. I was worried if I was missing anything. In case of options, there are a lot more things to look at as compared to a stock trade. So I thought to make this video to help others in placing their option trades. Hello friends, in today's video, we're gonna look at all the steps that you should take to sell a put spread or to sell a put vertical or to sell a put credit spread. They all three mean one and the same. So we'll go through these steps one by one so that you have a complete understanding of all the checks that you need to do before you hit send or before you hit a confirm button on your trading platform. So the ticker that we are interested in, Bank of America, and I want to sell a put spread on Bank of America. First thing, go to the option chain page or the option chain section or the trade section of your broker platform. Make sure you are looking at the correct ticker. In this case, it is Bank of America. Yes, that's what I'm interested in selling. Next, you should select option expiration date you're looking at. So there are multiple expiry periods listed here, but I'm interested in selling an option that expires 34 days from now because that's a monthly expiration, and that is what I'm interested in. So once you've identified the ticker and then you have identified the option expiration period, then only you should take the step of placing the trade. So to place the trade, we're going to expand this expiration cycle and look at all the strike prices. Since we want to sell a put option, we will focus all our attention on the right hand side because that's where the puts are listed. Next step is to select the strike prices. Since we are talking about a spread here, it is a multi-leg option trading strategy. The spread has got two legs. That means you will be selling one option and you will be buying another option. Since this is a put credit spread, means you are taking a net credit. So you will be selling a put option higher strike price and you will be buying back a put option with a lower strike price. The width of your spread will be the difference between the higher strike price and the lower strike price. Let's see how to do this. Let's say I am interested in selling 29 short option and buying back 27. Thus, it will create a put vertical with the width of $2. So once you've identified your short leg and a long leg, next thing is to go and execute the trade. So to do that, you will first sell the 29 strike price option, means you click on the bid of 29 strike price option. If you're on thinkorswim, you can then press the control button and then select the 27. So when you press a control button, it actually treats both the trades as a single trade. So if you see, it has added 27 and 29. Thinkorswim understands that this means it is a vertical trade, which is check. We are selling 29 and plus one means buying back 27, check. The expiration period is 18th April, check. It's a 29.27, it's a put. And this shows the amount of credit that you are getting. Make sure that you have a limit order. And this is, for how long is this order applicable? It should always be a day order. And then you can ignore the exchange. Let Thinkorswim route it to the best exchange. If you are not happy with the price you are getting, you could change it by clicking on the plus sign over here. Once you are satisfied with all the values, then you should press confirm and send to confirm the trade.